River's sensitive portrayal in Running on Empty earned him a Golden Globe Award and an Oscar nomination for Best Supporting Actor. River played the Hollywood game by being himself, even if he seemed awkward or irritated. He attended the premiere of the movie Batman wearing sneakers and a t-shirt. Journalists began to report he was a difficult interview.
Hey, River, how you doing?
Pretty good, thank you. And yourself?
I'm great. It's easy to get caught up in this Hollywood hoopla, isn't it?
Well, not for me, really. This is, it's easy to get, well, I mean, you're here, so you kind of have to, you know, attend and be normal. So.
Do you enjoy the hype of this event?
The hype? No, that really means nothing to me. It's more of the history of the awards that makes it so special for me. It's the first time I've attended these, and it'll be an experience. I really don't know what to expect yet.
What are you most looking forward to meeting?
Meeting? I haven't really thought about it. I just want to find the bathroom as soon as possible.
Well, good. I think there's one on the left.
River did not win the Best Supporting Actor Oscar, much to his relief.
Yeah, it would have meant hell. Just it was good enough to be in that company. What's the point of winning? All it does really is, you know, just what would follow: the expectation, the kind of whole political future. Beat it next time around. If you don't, you're considered a fail. I mean, it's just all that junk. I mean, it's not that it wouldn't have been great to win it, you know, and go down in history. But who needs it?
Brazilian superstar Milton Nascimento saw the Mosquito Coast on TV and was impressed by River Phoenix's talent and maturity.
Eu falei, meu Deus do céu, isso não é um ator. Isso é um espírito, é uma coisa, é muito forte demais. E se a gente se fala, contar as coisas.
Milton wrote this tribute in 1988 and became friends with River and his family. They shared concerns about the environment and the plight of native South Americans.
Ele sempre muito sério, sempre estudando tudo, né? Apesar da idade, apesar de tudo, ele mandava os seus filmes para o mundo e queria cuidar do mundo também.
Pois paralelo ao personagem, eu quis saber.
This is the first time Milton has sung the tribute since River's death.
Queria que fosses feliz.
River was exploring, always the boundaries, always where this is and where this leads, and no thought was foreign to him. Things could, you know, you could watch his eyes and you could see horizons in them.
And there's definitely something to be said for the sincerity of the seeker. It's said that when the seeker is sincere, then the answer comes.
I think that it's very important to establish a space for those who are not accounted for. Speaking of people that don't fit into a stereotype, it leaves out a lot of people in this world that aren't the model, you know, in a fashion sense of citizen. Or I protest that, and I think it's important to have a film that stirs up that idea, you know, that starts some sort of controversy.
In films like Dogfight and I Love You to Death, River gave extra depth to his offbeat characters. But he hungered for a more challenging role. In the independent film My Own Private Idaho, River gambled his reputation as a star by portraying a male prostitute.
And one evening he said, because he played a hustler, and he said, Udo, let's go to the real hustlers. I said, okay.
What is your reaction? Me looking like I am, let's say I'm 22, I'm just doing it, which is a very rare day, I assume.
Then I picked somebody out, and I interviewed the boy. And River was sitting there, totally concentrated of listening to what the boy had to say, because that's a practice. If you're an actor, you play a hustler, you don't have to be go to bed with people to know the feeling. I mean, you know, you can learn it another way.
Did you ever, like, have any sort of, like, care or emotional response to somebody who picked you up? Did you ever, like, feel like they were looking for more than just the lust?
No.
It's very cold.
Yeah, it was kind of, it was cold, yeah.
And very technical?
Mm-hmm.
And it was all for him, not for you.
Exactly.
So, Riff.
Sir.
Why are you doing this part?
I'm doing this part because I feel there's a theme that is stronger than any job anyone has. I find it just very ironic, just because of the terms that are laid down. What is success, right? And in this case, success, the motive, as you see in talking to these two people who are somewhat experienced and not how experienced they are, is money.
You know, I think there was definitely a kinship, you know, that he finds right at that moment when we ask him that question, that it is, you know, whether I go to, take a movie from Hollywood and get paid for that, or whether I'm, you know, one of these kids selling myself on the street, there's a connection between these two things. And what was unique about Private Idaho is that everyone lived in the same house. All the actors, I wouldn't say everyone, but the majority of the actors, the male actors in the film, myself and the director and a few other people lived in the house. There was no furniture in the house. In fact, I think people slept in sleeping bags. And I think the concept was to make everybody feel like they were a street kid, like they didn't have a place to sleep.
Like most teenagers, River Phoenix had experimented with drugs and alcohol. But living amongst real street kids brought with it the harsh realities of street life.
Well, I'll put it to you this way. I remember after River had done heroin, me asking him, is this the first time you've ever done it? And him telling me no. But I also remember not believing him. And that was during the making of My Own Private Idaho. I wouldn't want to blame anybody for that. You can't really say that it's, you know, the circumstances surrounding one character choice. He made the choice. He decided to do the role. And, you know, any actor will tell you, you can try to imagine it or you can live it. And, you know, his style was, I want to live it.
River himself wrote the key scene of the film, where his confused and lost character struggles through his pain to make a human connection.
I mean, for me, I could love someone even if I, you know, wasn't paid for it. I love you, and you don't pay me.
Mike.
I really want to kiss you, man.